I'm Günther Fink. I'm an associate professor at the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health, and I was part of a research project as part of the Saving Brains Economics Project. Our project focused on quantifying the economic effects of early life developmental problems. So there's lots of research going on right now trying to show how important early childhood development is. But there's not really a number that quantifies how much of an impact these kind of early childhood developmental challenges have in the long run. So the main objective, and I think the main contribution of our project really was to come up with an estimate for each country and also globally for the impacts that we are seeing in terms of the long-term consequences for early life growth faltering and in general for delays in early childhood development. But the project had three parts, and I think the exciting part of the project, and I think that really would not have happened without the support of the Canadian government through Grand Challenges Canada, was really to bring together a multidisciplinary group. I think we always talk about multidisciplinary research, but in practice it's hard to do because without external support, it's hard to get people into one room. So in this case, we really had medical doctors, we had economists like myself, we had epidemiologists, we had pediatricians all working together, trying to really figure out what does it mean to have delays in early childhood development and what does it mean for the long-term impact. So the modeling we did was really trying to go through the life cycle of children. So what will happen? Okay, so let's focus on physical growth. So children face all kinds of adversity. We looked at about 25 types of adversity, ranging from being born too early, to being born too light, to being exposed to malaria, being exposed to diarrhea, being exposed to maternal depression. There's many, many things that can go wrong in the first few months or first 1,000 days of people's life. And then to see how that impacts children's development, and then from development, how it affects children's progression through schooling, and then with their schooling attainment, how it will affect the labor market outcomes. So we chose this model that tracks children over their lifetime. So essentially, somebody born next year will go to school in about 6 or 7 years, will finish school when they're 18, will enter the labor market, will work. Throughout their lives, they will earn less because they completed less schooling, and overall they'll be worse off. And the whole idea of the project, which I think was quite exciting, was to come up with one global number for this kind of economic burden or loss or lost economic opportunity for children born in low and middle income countries today.